students, today we are going to learn a new lesson, very interesting lesson. So many experiments are present in this lesson. So all of you carefully listen to the class. Okay. So our lesson is chapter 9, physical and chemical changes. Physical and chemical changes. Physical and chemical changes. Have you heard the word physical and chemical? Physical means, so we can identify on the basis of our view, on the basis of our view. If some changes are occurred, so we can identify that changes through observing. Through observing, that changes are called physical changes. So another type of changes we cannot identify through the on the basis of observing. If we so that changes are called chemical changes. There are in our science there are two types of changes are present. First one is physical and second one is the chemical change. Physical and chemical changes can be classified as two types. First one is physical change. Then second one, chemical change. Okay. What do you mean by physical properties? How do you know physical properties? If studying physical properties, first of all we learn about physical change. What do you mean by physical change? Yes, any change to the physical properties of a substance is called a physical change. A physical change means any change to the physical properties of a substance is called a physical change. But from this, what do you mean by physical properties? What are the physical properties of a substance? Yes, the size, shape, color and state of the substances are the physical properties of a substance. In physical change, the physical properties of a substances are, the physical properties are included the size, first one, size, shape, color and state. State includes solid. We know that the matter have three states: solid, liquid, and gaseous states. Solid, liquid, and gas. So the three states: solid, liquid, and gas. These are gases of a substance. These are physical properties of a substance. All of you understood? Yes. Today we are learn about what the changes happening to a substance. So changes can be classified as two. First one, physical change, and the second one is the chemical change. What do you mean by physical change? Physical change, any change to the physical properties of a substance is called physical change. That means the physical properties of a substance includes the size of the substance, the shape of the substance, the color of the substance, the state of the substance. The states include solid, liquid, and gases. We know that the solid solid can be converted into liquid, liquid can be converted into gases, gas can be converted into liquid, liquid can be converted into solid. Solid can be converted into liquid through melting, liquid can be converted into gas through evaporation. Then liquids can be converted into solid through what? Through condensation, etc. Like that. So different processes are needed to change the states of a substances. Okay. So if we change the state of the substances, that change is called physical changes. That change is called a physical changes. First physical properties of a substance is size. We know that if we take a sheet of paper, we know that the size of the paper. See, it's a square shape. It has a square shape. Then a big square is this, and this size, we know that if we observe the paper, we can see the size of the paper. Then after we cut the paper, into two pieces. Then again I cut the paper into another two pieces. What happened to the paper, sheet of paper? It can be its size and shape. Its size is changed. So this property, this is the physical property of the paper. But if physical property is changed to the paper? Yes, it's the size. Size is changed. Its size is changed. Okay. Then, size is a physical property of a substance. Then shape. Then what happened? Next, another we can say that if we burn this paper, what happened? Yes, we know that after burning the paper, we get what? Yes, we get ash. So another, we get another substance. So that is also a change of the substance. Then, if we take the paper into this type, what happened to the paper? If any new substances is formed? No, if we can see the paper itself and its shape is changed. So shape, size, etc. are the physical properties of a substances. If any change to the size, shape, color and state of a substances is changed, is called a physical change. That change is called a physical change. That change is called a physical change. Any change to the physical properties of a substance is called a physical change. Any change to the physical properties. The physical properties includes the size, shape, color and state. The states include solid, liquid and gas. Any change to the physical properties of a substance is called a physical change. All of you understood physical change? Yes. Example. Next thing. This physical change is an reversible change. Reversible change. Physical change is a reversible change. Reversible change. The physical change is also called a reversible change. Reversible change means if we take a sheet of paper and cut the paper into different pieces, what happened? We know that since the shape and size is changed, but no new substances is not formed. The paper remains in the paper itself. So no new substances is formed, that is reversible change. No new substances is formed, that is reversible change, that is physical change. For if a change is happening to a substances, no new are formed in a physical change. All of you understood about physical change? Another example we can say about physical changes. Cutting down trees, wood. If we cut the wood, what happens? Yes, its shape is changed. Shape and size is changed. The physical properties of the wood is changed. Then after cutting down the trees, we burn the wood. What happens? The wood is turned into, the wood is changed into charcoal. The wood is changed into charcoal with the liberation, with the evolution of carbon dioxide, with the evolution of carbon dioxide. Okay, there is new substance is formed, that is charcoal or ash is formed. There is new substance is formed. So it is not a physical change, not a physical change. That change is called a chemical change. That change is called a chemical change. And a chemical change means that if during a chemical change is taken place, there is a new substance formed. There is a new substance formed. Such a type of change is called a chemical change. In physical change, new substances are not formed. So it is called a physical change. It is only changes happening to the size, shape, color and state of the substances. Okay, next we learn about chemical change. Chemical change means any change in which one or more new substances are formed is called as chemical change. One or more substances, new substances are formed is called as chemical change. If we take a sheet of paper after cutting paper into different pieces, that time there is physical changes takes place because there is the changes is happening in the physical properties of the substances, physical properties of the sheet of paper. Okay, so we can say that is physical change. Then if we, after cutting down the pieces of paper, if we burn the paper, what happens? We get ashes. We get ashes of the paper and through the evolution of gas. So we get the new substances. So if any change in which one or more new substances are formed, that type of changes is called a chemical changes. That type of changes is called a chemical changes. Example for chemical changes, if we cut down wood, that what happened to the wood, physical changes happen because its size and shape is changed. After cutting down, if we burn the wood, what we get the charcoal with the liberation of carbon dioxide. We get the ash with the liberation of carbon dioxide. We get two new substances, that is charcoal and carbon dioxide. So if a change in which one or more new substances is formed, new substances are formed is called what? Chemical change. Okay, burning of wood and cutting it into small pieces are considered as two different types of changes. Cutting it into small pieces are example for physical changes, and the burning of wood is an example for chemical changes. If we burn the wood, we get two new substances. We get new substances, that is charcoal and carbon dioxide. So it is called as chemical change. That change is called as chemical change. Then another example we can say that we can say that the burning of candle. Burning of candle is another example of physical change. If we burn the candle, what happened to the wax? The wax become melting, and again we can recreate or reverse. We can change the process, and again we can make the candle. So its physical properties is also get changed. Its size and shape and its state are changed. If we burn a candle, what happens? Yes, if we burn the candle, the wax becomes melts, and its state. It is at first the candle is under solid state, and if you burn the candle is melt into liquid form, so its state is converted, and so we can say that it is a physical change. It is a physical change. Okay, there is no new substances are formed. The wax remains in the wax itself because its physical properties are changed. Its state is changed. Its solid state is changed into liquid form. So it is an example for physical change. Okay, next what we learn? We learn about chemical change. What is chemical change? Any change in which one or more new substances are formed is called a chemical change. Example for chemical changes, we can say that burning of wood. Then another example, we can say that burning of wood and paper, we get two new products, that is charcoal or ash, or a gas is liberated, that is carbon dioxide. Next example, we can say that rusting of iron means turub. Okay, the rusting of iron is stage flakes. If the iron is rusted, we get new substances. So we can say that if the iron gets rusted, it will contact with the air or moisture, so form a new substance, that is rust is formed. So we can say that a new substances are formed. So it is an example for chemical change. Then next we learn about, in your textbook some activities are given. First activity, cut a piece of paper into four small pieces. What happened? Its size, its shape is changed. So the paper gets a change, that is physical change. Yes, what happened to the piece of paper? Yes, its size and shape is changed, so it is considered as a physical change. Next activity is taken as collect the chalk dust lying on the floor. If we write the chalk on the board, some powders of small pieces of chalks are present on the floor. Then take the chalk pieces and crush small pieces of chalk into dust or powdered form. Then add a little water to the dust. Powder of the chalk. What happened? Make a paste and roll it into the shape of a piece of chalk. What happens? We can make again the chalk. So there is also a change in the physical properties is takes place. There is no new substances are formed. So it is also an example for physical change. Once again, here in your textbook, some activities are given for understanding about physical change. First activity says about take a piece of paper and cut the piece of paper into four square pieces. Then cut each square pieces further into four square pieces. Then we can take the original shape of that paper if we are joining or paste the paper pieces. Okay, so if there is from that experiment or activity we cannot get a new product, so we can change the physical properties of the paper, so its size, shape, so we can say that it is a physical change. Another example or another activity is given, that is if we take some small pieces of chalks and powder it, then after powdering the chalk pieces, we add some drops of water into make it the powder of chalk pieces into a paste form, and make it the chalk paste of chalk powder into the shape of a chalk piece. After drying it, what we get? We get a chalk again. So reversible change, there is no new substances is formed. So we can say that it is also an example for physical change. Next, another activity is given is that is take some ice in a glass or plastic tumbler. Take some ice in a glass, then melt the small portion of the ice by placing the tumbler in the sun. For we know that if we take some ice cubes from the refrigerator, take the ice cube in a glass of water and place the glass of ice cubes into the sun, after some time what happens? The ice melts into water. So we can say that there is also a change is happen in the physical properties of the ice cubes. That is, salt ice cubes are solid in state. So if we allow the heat to the ice cubes, what happened? The solid state of the ice cubes are changed into the liquid form. So there is the state of the substances is changed, and then again we can refrigerate the ice liquid, we get the ice cubes again. So we cannot get, there is no new substances, so we can consider it is an example for physical change. Another activity is given about understanding the physical change, that is boil some water in a container. Then we, after some time, if we boil the water in the high flame, after some time what happened? We can see some steam rising from the surface of the water. Then we can from the boiling, then if we cover the boiling water with a lid, after something what happened, we can see that some water drops are present on the surface of the boiling water. So what happened in the inner side surface of the pan? Yes, we know that there is the water is changed into gases, and the gas is condensed and forms the liquid. There is also the changes of state is takes place, that is, it is a physical properties of a substance. If any change to the physical properties of a substance, that is a physical change. Okay. Another example, another activity is given, that is, first of all, we take a hacksaw blade with a pair of tongs, then keep the tip of free end of the flame of a gas stove, then wait for a few minutes. What happened to the, first of all, we take a hacksaw blade, then what we do, and again, then we burn the tip of the hacksaw blade. After something, what happened? Yes, we can. What happened? The color is changed. The color of the hacksaw blade is changed. So the color of a substance is a physical property of a substance. So physical property of a substance is acquired. The physical property of a substance is changed. So we can say that it is also an example for physical change. So from these activities, the activity 6.1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, we can say that if any change to the physical properties of a substance, the physical properties include the size, shape, color, and state. State means solid, liquid, and gas. The conversion of solid to liquid to gas, then gas to liquid, then liquid to solid. These conversion is takes place, or the state of the changes takes place in the state of a substance. That is, any change to the physical properties of a substance is called a physical change. So physical change is an irreversible change, that is, there is no new substances are formed. If any change to the physical properties happening, then there is no new substances formed, so we can say that it is a physical change. Next, we learn about chemical change. Chemical change means any change in which one or more new substances are formed is called a chemical change. Example, we learn the burning of wood, burning of paper, then another example, rusting of iron is an example for what? Chemical change. chemical change. What do you mean by rusting? The rust is an example. Rusting of iron is an example for chemical change. What do you mean by rusting? What do you mean by rusting? What do you mean by rusting? Okay, well, let me listen. What do you mean by rusting? In the atmosphere, it forms a red layer which is called rust, and the process is called rusting. And the process is called rusting. What do you mean by rusting? When substance is made of iron, then we can say that then axe, then knife, etc. are made up of iron. So the substances made of iron are exposed to oxygen and moisture in the atmosphere. Or exposed to oxygen and moisture in the atmosphere, it forms a red layer. It forms a red layer which is called rust. And the process is called rusting. But that why will be rusting? When a substance made of iron is exposed to oxygen and moisture. It forms a red layer is called rust. This process is called rusting. Once again about rusting. Here, rusting means when a substance made of iron, when any substance made of iron is exposed to oxygen or moisture in the atmosphere, it forms a red layer. It forms a red layer on the surface of the substance made of iron, that is called rust. And process of making rust on the surface of the iron materials is called rusting. That is that in rusting, that is 4Fe+ the iron that the substance made up of iron is exposed to the oxygen. What happened? The rust is formed. The chemical formula for rust. Rust is formed. 2Fe2O3 is formed. Fe2O3 gives 2Fe2O3. chemical formula for Fe2O3, Fe2O3 and H2O. Is the first. So chemical formula for rust. Once again, rusting means the iron. Iron is exposed to oxygen or moisture. It will form a red layer on the surface, that is rust. 2 Fe2O3, Fe2O3 and H2O is the chemical formula for rust. Chemical formula for rust. Rusting, all of you understood about rusting. Rusting means when a substance made of iron is exposed to oxygen and moisture in the atmosphere, it forms a red layer, is called a rust. This process is called rusting. Here, what the chemical formula for rust is Fe2O3 and H2O. Fe2O3 and H2O. Okay, next one, some examples for chemical changes are given. First of all, we learn about metallic oxides. Metallic oxides.
Go back the magnesium ribbon? No.
So there is a new substance is formed. So there is chemical changes is take place. The magnesium ribbon is changed into ash by burning. Ash by burning. So the change can be represented. The magnesium, if the magnesium ribbon is burned, so the change can be represented by magnesium plus oxygen. How the burning of magnesium ribbon takes place? Magnesium, chemical formula for magnesium, G plus oxygen, magnesium plus oxygen. We know that for burning, oxygen is needed. So magnesium plus oxygen, magnesium plus oxygen gives, magnesium plus oxygen gives magnesium oxide. Magnesium plus oxygen gives magnesium. Magnesium oxide, MgO, MgO. Here we get a metal oxide, that is metal means magnesium oxide. So metal oxide is an example for chemical change. If we get a metal oxide through a change, if it's chemical change, we can say that here a chemical change takes place. So burning of magnesium ribbon, first of all what we do, yes, first of all we take a magnesium ribbon, then clean the magnesium, tip of the magnesium ribbon with the sandpaper. After cleaning, we burn the tip of the magnesium ribbon. We can see that a white, bright white colored flame is come from the burning of magnesium ribbon. Then after burning the magnesium ribbon, after burning the magnesium ribbon, we get a new substance. We get the ash of the magnesium ribbon. So we get a new substance. So we can say that the burning of magnesium ribbon is an example for chemical change. The magnesium ribbon is react with the oxygen, we get an oxide, metallic oxide, that is magnesium oxide. So it is an example for, it is an example for chemical change. It is an example for chemical change. We get a new product, that is magnesium oxide. Burning of magnesium ribbon is an example for which change? Chemical change. Burning of magnesium ribbon is an example for chemical change. The magnesium reacts with the oxygen to form a new burning of magnesium ribbon. How we get a new product by the burning of magnesium ribbon? The magnesium ribbon react with the oxygen. So we get a new product, that is magnesium oxide. So magnesium oxide is an example. Oxide is an example. Metallic oxide is an example for chemical change. So burning of magnesium ribbon is an example for what? Chemical change. So all of you understood the two changes takes place in a substance, physical and chemical changes. What do you mean by physical changes? Physical changes means any change to the physical properties of a substance is called a physical change. Example for physical change is burning of a candle. Then what all activity we do? Yes. Then changing of ice into liquid, etc. are example for physical change. Then what is chemical change? Any change, a change in which two or more new substances are formed is called a chemical change. Example, rusting of iron, then burning of wood, etc. are example for, then burning of magnesium ribbon, etc. are example for chemical changes. Okay, all of you read your textbook, then okay, thank you.